You tuned in to the Black People's Podcast. You tuned in to the Black People's Podcast with Bread Man. Let's get the numbers up. We got to make sure we good. Waiting on my green light. Waiting on my green light. You tuned in to the Black People's Podcast with Bread Man. Make sure you hit like. Make sure you hit share. Make sure you hit subscribe. Make sure you hit like, make sure you hit share, and make sure you hit subscribe. Bread Gang, stand up. Waiting on my green light. Are we good? Yeah, we in there. We in there like swimwear. I got a whole docket for y'all tonight. We're gonna be talking about Ronald Green. Right, we're going to be talking about Ronald. That's Ronald Green. Who is Ronald Green? Huh? We're definitely going to get down to the bottom of that, of exactly who Ronald Green is. Then also, we're going to be talking about the black man whose daughter's ashes were spread out all over the streets by some dirty cops. We know who you are, by some dirty cops. We know you did it on purpose, by some dirty cops. We talking about it tonight on the Black People's Podcast. Also, we're gonna be talking about what happened in the Tennessee jail. We're gonna break that down, right? Of how another inmate died in the hands of the police. I wanna get down to the particulars. We're gonna break it down, but he was taunted by his own victimizers, by his own killers, before his death. We're going to talk about that. We're also going to follow up on the Andrew Brown case. The video was released. We have to follow up on that, of course. We definitely have to follow up on that. And last but not least, hopefully, we'll be talking about some bread. Where the bread at? Right, you tuned in to the Black People's Podcast. Make sure you hit like, make sure you hit share, make sure you hit subscribe. Right now, we got to get the numbers up. So we're going to take our time. Make sure you hit like right now. Make sure you share right now. Let's go. Get those numbers up. Let's go. The berry, the sweet of the juice. You got that juice. You got that juice. You got that juice. You got that power. Yeah, power to the people. Yeah. All power to the people. Yeah. The power's in the people. In the streets mobbing, ripping good over evil. Look. Power. Power to the people. Yeah. All power to the people. In the people, burning and looting, repping good over evil. Look, the power's in the people. Uh-huh. Should have asked for equity, but we rather.
Let's go. Share. Get the numbers up. You're tuning in to the Black People's Podcast. Let's go. It's light work tonight. The phone lines will be open. Call in and talk your shit.
They out and watch Judas and the Black Messiah. Them crackers, they want me shot. That's the truth, too. Black man magic. I might hit their ass with voodoo.
I need double digits, y'all. Let's go.
Black at this point, go grab your who's who. I rep that north side till I die, and that's a blue. Clue. Look, I ain't never want the recognition. All praises due, man. We in full submission. Now that I got your attention, you should know you got that juice too. Non-GMO, please don't let them people fool you. Power, yeah. Power to the people. Yeah. All power to the people. Yeah. The power's in the people.
Let's go, Bread Gang. Stand up. Get the numbers up. Help me get the numbers up. Where my chat at? Where's my chat? Let's go.
Power to the people. Powers in the people, burning and looting, repping good over evil. Look, juice.
Bread gang, stand up. You tuned in to the Black People's Podcast with your favorite host, Bread Man. Light work. Yo.
We're moving kind of slow tonight. You know, I'm not the one to complain, but I don't think we're ready yet. Right? I don't think we're ready yet. Y'all gonna make me go and grab him. See, I ain't even wanna do this. Y'all, man, I ain't even wanna do this. God dang. Get my numbers up, man. Get my numbers up. I need double digits. Let's go.
Meet Mac. Now she uses HoneyBook.
I need double digits. Salute to IG. IG know what it do. IG wanted to know what it do. Make sure y'all subscribe to Breadman TV on YouTube. Let's go, man.
Smoke there we some, go. Bitch.
There we go.
GK. Hold up.
Talk Let's stop playing, man. Let's stop playing.
MCPH real nigga, polo fuck that heel figure, made myself a ghetto star, on the slab sipping bar, smoking weed setting white, the mother nigga shit don't come back right, that's how niggas get pop, trying to get the cheaper price, watch your paper.
Yo, did I tell y'all I'm putting Pornhub on trial tonight? I'm actually putting Pornhub on trial tonight, bro. Get the numbers up, man. It's going down. Let's go.
Keeping the game, hitting the corner in the candy thing, sitting on leather, gripping the grain.
Yeah. Good weed, good drink, big money.
Hey.
Rolling in something far and no leather gripping.
Yeah.
I handle my business, so I think I deserve it.
Hey.
Oh.
Hey.
I came in the dope, I said it before. I never fuck a hoe without head no more. I never pull up with nothing less than a foe. And I smoke cigars, it ain't just for the show. I'm blessed from the dope, and known for my sit eye. I send a nigga baby mama home with a spit eye. You can have a bitch nigga, I ain't send him in now. Smoke weed and freestyle, no instrument out. Pin out, flip through the biggest streets of PA. Motherfuck the judge, prosecutor, and the DA. Head to the H where the hoes are fucked three-way, two-way, four-way. Anyway the pro say, never hear a hoe say. No I won't, no I can't stop it, and no I don't. Cause a bitch know I might just explode and slap in the face with a pie.
Let's go, let's go, let's go. Get the numbers up. You tune in to the Black People's Podcast with Bread, man. The show's about to get started in about 2 minutes. Let's go.
Good weed, good drink, big money.
Hey.
Rolling in something foreign, no leather gripping.
Yeah.
I handle my
you
business, so
know
I think
is,
I deserve it.
Hey, 16.5 a piece, hey. Scary, nigga, USDA.
Hey.
I grind hard, and play hard.
Salute to the chat. What up, Pharaoh? What up, 2B in me? Salute. Let's go.
Damn.
Make sure y'all sharing. Get the likes up. Let's go.
Do tricks. Hit the brakes. Hit the light. And voila, they go them bricks.
Ha ha.
Through the hood. Sitting on some big wheels.
Yeah.
Niggas copping white. Turn flips like cartwheels. Trap star, my next tail trip all day. Day. Riding dirty. 3 9s and a 4-way.
Yeah. Big money,
hey,
big money, man.
In something
hey.
Foreign, no
we only ride the best.
Yeah. I handle my business,
it's one and only,
so
big homie.
I deserve it.
Hey.
No. Try to told you I'm thug.
Hey.
Yeah.
Sun foreign, I'm torn on foreign land. Worldwide, I'm known for the arm and hand. Heard the streets, I'm a wanted man. So it's on again. Started with the block, hit it brick by brick. Then I charted with the rock, nigga, hit by hit. I'm retarded with the Glock, nigga, clip by clip. The competition is none, they deceased.
Yeah, we here. I see y'all. Let's go. Now we ready. Let's go.
Skit stole like a football. Hove used to cook raw. Now I got the game.
Turn up, Bread Gang. Let's go.
Sure, y'all niggas want war. Y'all got it backwards. Y'all shit want raw.
Y'all should want more. Facts. What up, Black Jade? I see you. Happy birthday, Queen. I got something for you. Let's go.
Rolling in something foreign, no leather gripping.
Yeah.
I handle my business, so I think I deserve it.
Hey.
Hey.
Yeah.
Good weed, good drink, big money.
Hey.
Rolling in something foreign.
No call lines, the phone lines will be open tonight.
And so I think I deserve it.
Hey.
No.
Hey. Yeah.
Yo, welcome. You tuned in to the Black People's Podcast. Y'all don't get right. Y'all don't even get your mind right till boys start playing Pimp C. That's what I got to do. I gotta get hood on you straight out the door to get your mind right. It's all good. We here. Get the numbers up. Make sure you hit like, make sure you hit share, and make sure you hit subscribe. Right? I got the docket up. I got the docket up, and it's relatively light work. Salute to Black Jay. Salute to Pharaoh. Salute to Me and Me. Hemingway, Marcus Hemingway, I see you in there. Marcus Hemingway, I see you in there. And since you talking, I didn't want to do it, but since you talking, yo, let me put you on the Summer Jam screen early. You know, we like to take our debates worldwide, man. You know, I really put in the work, my G. I really put in the work. So here's an example. We have, this is what you call a disgruntled customer. You feel me? This is what you call a disgruntled customer. This is what we do here at the Black People's Podcast. Salute to my guy though. Salute to my guy, Mr. At Marcus Hemingway. We're gonna make you a star. No, not that one. Not that one. Here we go.
You're sitting on the couch. I'm sitting on the floor. You have a car. I have a car. You have a roof over your head. I have a roof over your head. I probably got more money than you, and that's that.
Hey, go ahead.
You're sitting on the couch. I'm sitting on the floor. You have a car. I have a car. You have a roof over your head. I have a roof over your head. I probably got more money than you, and that's that. Nigga, you're not shit. You didn't make it, so you're mad at us. Nigga, them white people that you applied for the job, they didn't hire you. Them white people that you went for a job for, they don't want you. So get used to it, black guy. They don't want your black bald head ass with that fucking stupid ass shit on you, looking like a fucking AirPod, like you fly airplanes or something. They don't want you, bro. So all you're going to do is be a nigga that get mad because you didn't make it. Don't take your black ass anger out on niggas like us, because guess what? We all mad, just like you. But see, we take it out on the right people. You want to take it out on women, everybody who don't believe with your fucked up logic.
Yo. Yo. salute to that man, you feel me? It's okay to take an L. It's okay to take an L, but you gotta take that L gracefully. You gotta take that L gracefully. This is what we do. This is what we do at the Black People's Podcast. Make sure you hit like, make sure you hit share, make sure you hit subscribe. Right? Right? Just doing a little cleanup work. Don't let that go over your head. Salute to the Bread Gang. Salute to King Me Now. Huh? Salute to King Me Now. Now, I want to start off with Ronald Green. I have to start off with the Ronald Green story. Right? Another man who died unarmed by the hands of the police. Right? But the way that they have tried to cover this story up has been extremely sinister. And now that the truth is starting to come out, not everybody on skates. Right? Not everybody on skates, but we got to continue to apply the pressure. If I'm not mistaken, this happened damn near a year ago. Right? But now the footage and the details have been released. So I'm gonna go straight to the video. Right? Let's go straight to the video. Let me see if I can get it up. You're tuned in to the Black People's Podcast. Make sure you hit like, make sure you hit share, make sure you subscribe right now. Make sure you hit like, make sure you hit share, make sure you hit subscribe right now. Parental discretion, viewer discretion is advised. Viewer discretion is advised. I'm busting this case down right here with y'all. We're talking about Ronald Green, RIP. We're about to bust this case down. Let's go.
Newly obtained video by CNN shows haunting images of Ronald Green's last moments while in custody of Louisiana State Police in May of 2019.
Why'd you run from?
All you do is speed a little bit and run a red light.
The video shows what appears to be a supervising officer arriving on scene, engaging with responding officers while Green remains cuffed on the ground, face down. After an early video shows him being beaten and tased, police claiming Green had resisted arrest after attempting to pull him over.
Don't you turn over. You lay that, lay on your belly. Lay on your belly.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
Don't lay on your belly. Okay,
yes, sir.
Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
In the video, we hear Green in distress as he continues to be restrained by officers.
I was going to sit him up, but I didn't want to spit blood all over us.
Minutes after the supervisor engages with officers, medical aid is rendered by emergency personnel on site for the first time. Green appears to be unresponsive.
It took three of them to take him down.
That's a lie. That's a goddamn lie. That's a goddamn lie right there. That's a goddamn lie. This is what they do. I'm so sick, and this is George Floyd all over again. George Floyd was not an anomaly. Don't let this go over your head, yo. We're going to break this shit down like game film. I heard him early in the video tell him it hurt, don't it? Huh? When you was inflicting pain on this man, when you had him restrained. I know what y'all do. I know what y'all doing. You told him it hurt, don't it? Huh? And then when everybody showed up, When the ambulance showed up, they're like, "Yo, this man, he unresponsive. He out of there. What happened? It took three of us to take him down. That's a goddamn lie. You drug him, you kicked him, you beat him. After you got him out of a car that was already wrecked, he wrecked the car and he was incapacitated. He couldn't do nothing."
The car visible in the new body cam footage shows Green's vehicle that sustained damage. Lee Merritt, attorney for the Green family, says the state police response was outrageous.
This was a supervisor who showed up to the scene. He didn't even acknowledge Ronald on the ground.
Green's family says they were originally told the cause of death was a car crash following a high-speed pursuit.
This has been a cover-up from the very moment it happened. My son wasn't meant to walk away from that. He was purposely killed. He was murdered.
Fact.
But state officials tell CNN that Louisiana State Police were investigating Ronald Green's death as a criminal matter the same night
God.
Of the incident.
Oh, my God.
Two officers involved in the...
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Again, viewer discretion is advised, ladies and gentlemen. We have to pay attention to what's going on. This is a black man in a backcountry road who attempted to run away from the police. Now it's just him back there with all these racist-ass lawmen. And they jacking him up every second along the way. From the time that he crashed the car to the time that they pulled him out, jacked him up, handcuffed him. Here you're watching him under a car handcuffed and the officer is kicking him and standing on top of his body. Facts.
High speed pursuit.
This has been a cover up from the very moment it happened. My son wasn't meant to walk away from that. He was purposely killed. He was murdered.
But state officials tell CNN that Louisiana State Police were investigating Ronald Green's death as a criminal matter the same night of the incident. Two officers involved in the incident were reprimanded for their actions. A third officer died in a single car crash last year. An autopsy report obtained by CNN lists the cause of death as cocaine-induced agitated delirium complicated by motor vehicle collision, physical struggle, inflicted head injury, and restraint. No written incident reports were provided to the medical examiner despite requests. No medical records were provided, neither was detailed information about the car crash.
They were left in the dark. They were stonewalled. By the state police, which again is another policy that shows how systemic this is.
The report also states that lacerations on Green's head were inconsistent with the motor vehicle collision injury and most consistent with multiple impacts from a blunt object.
Okay, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Yo. So is it just enough for them to lose their jobs or be reprimanded as if they work at McDonald's for this? If Derek Chauvin just did time, is doing time, just got found guilty for doing the same thing, why are they still walking around free? Why have they not been charged with this man's murder now that they've been busted for a cover-up? Where are the charges? Where's the outrage?
Aaron, look, this video.
And I want to be clear. This is we're watching. I'm appalled. I don't even want to show the whole video and watch this man get tortured and beaten. Let me go back to the beginning. You're gonna hear the man. He's telling y'all, I'm sorry. I'm scared. We've heard this before. I'm sorry. I'm scared. Don't kill me. And we got officers in the back talking about, that hurt, don't it? Yeah, boy, we know it hurt, don't it? Because you're there to now you're there to teach him a lesson. I know who you are. You wanna teach this black buck a lesson. Come on, man. We gotta stop. Let's go. We got to stop, yo. You tune in to the Black People's Podcast. Make sure you hit like, make sure you hit share, and make sure you hit subscribe, man. Get the numbers up. Let's stop playing and get the numbers up, man. This is real talk. We have to stop. These officers need to be charged with murder. Point blank period. Now I got buffering. We can get you out of there. You tune into the Black People's Podcast. Allow me to continue. So how far are they gonna let this one go? What is it gonna take to get these people charged? Because we just saw what happened. Right there in front of our face is no doubt. There's no doubt about what we saw happen. This man is gone. Murdered and tortured right before our eyes. Then there was a cover-up on top of it. Let me go to the comments. Pharaoh Breeze says, we need to force the entire system to be reconstructed. Right? Marcus Hemingway says, we need to comply. Says comply. I guess he's saying we need to comply. I see you in there, Black Jay. Happy birthday. I see you in there going to work. Salute. Salute to Always on 10. Welcome. Talk to me in the chat. What do y'all think about this? I see a cover up. I don't smell nothing. I see a cover up and I see murder. And I'm wondering why they have not been charged. Let me see if I can find a few more details. Dang it. A few more details on this story. But I need y'all talking to me. In the chat. And look, I'm going to open up the phone lines as well. Phone line's going to be open all night. 832-598-1641. I'm going to pop these topics off, and then I'm just going to open up the line. Right? I'm going to pop the topics off, then we're just going to open up the line. We're going to keep it pushing. But this is murder, ladies and gentlemen. Make no mistake about it. Salute to this man's family for, you know, still trying to get justice. A lot of times we don't even hear about the story no more. They're really going to work. They're really going to work on his behalf. Right? So let me see how this story is being covered nationally. Let me see what the New York Times, right, or BBC, let me see if they're on it yet and what they have to say about it. Right? Let me see what the Washington Post has to say about it. Let's go to some of these major outlets, because I know people see CNN. Oh, look at, okay, that's cool. That's cool. You tuned in to the Black People's Podcast with Bread Man. Make sure you hit like, make sure you hit share, make sure you subscribe right now. Make sure you like, make sure you share, and make sure you subscribe right now. Let's just go to news. And y'all talk to me in the chat. Let me know what y'all think about this. I know what I think about it. They should be charged the same way. And matter of fact, I don't even think that Derek Chauvin got the right charges. He should have got torture. And if they broke down that video, we're gonna see torture. This has been going on since Rodney King, my G. That's what people not understanding. Right? Every blue moon, we catch their hand in the cookie jar. Right? Doing the nasty things that they do on the regular. Okay, on the regular. And we don't attack it. We don't charge them properly. These are cases of torture. Make no mistake about it. It's been going on since we got here. You think just because they don't have on no knickerbockers, right? That it's not the same thing, that it's not a lynching of a black man. What you think because they don't, right? Right? Because they ain't in the old 19, they didn't ride out in the old 1950 pickup truck with the burning crosses. No, they rode out in a 2018, 2019 Tahoe. Same shit. What are we talking? Get my numbers up. You tune into the Black People's Podcast with Bread Man. Make sure you hit like, make sure you hit share, make sure you hit subscribe. What are we talking though? I got some of the story up right here. I'm gonna read through it. This is CBS. Salute to Swayze TV. Swayze TV, stay on deck. Stay on deck. I'm probably going to need you next. Stay on deck. Let me get the display screen up. This is going to come by way of what? CBS? CBS? Okay. Body cam video shows shackled motorist Ronald Green was ordered face down. During deadly arrest. Beaten and shackled by Louisiana State Troopers, black motorist Ronald Green desperately tried to roll over in what may have been a struggle to breathe, but was ordered to stay on his belly, according to the camera video released by the Louisiana State Police. A long secret autopsy report obtained by the Associated Press cited Green's head injuries and the way he was restrained as factors in his 2019 death. It was also noted he had high levels of cocaine and alcohol in his system, as well as a broken breastbone and a torn aorta. I beat the ever living F out of him, choked him, and everything else trying to get him under control, Trooper Chris Hollingsworth can be heard telling a fellow officer in the newly released batch video. All of a sudden, he just went limp. I thought he was dead. I'll read that again. I beat the ever living F out of him. I choked him. And everything else trying to get him under control. Trooper Chris Hollingsworth can be heard telling a fellow officer in the newly released video, all of a sudden, he went limp. I thought he was dead. That sounds like a confession, y'all. That sounds like a confession, y'all. You all got that on body camera. Now he's asking questions, trying to cover up his tracks. The other officer asks the phone. Huh? At which point Hollingsworth switches his camera off. The cover up begins. The footage and the autopsy report add to the growing wealth of details about Green's death, which is long surrounded by allegations of a cover-up and is now in the subject of a federal civil rights investigation. Louisiana State Police initially blamed his death on a car crash and made no mention of use of force by officers. On Friday, after 2 years of refusing to explain Green's death and under mounting public pressure, the state police released the body camera footage related to Green's arrest, despite the ongoing investigations. While the premature release of investigating files and video evidence can have a negative effect on the criminal justice proceedings of any investigation, LSP remains confident in the judicial system that it will remain fair of this incident. I want to hold up right here because I'm confused, and I want my people, I want my bread gang helping me out on this, because I'm a little confused. So this is turned into a civil rights, a civil rights investigation, correct? Correct? I'm talking to the bread gang. This is what I want to know. Is that the same thing as a criminal investigation? Can they still bring criminal charges? Because if they can't, then I ain't trying to hear that. Right, if this is what I think it is, I don't care about the money. Right, y'all talk to me in the chat. The phone lines are open. 832-598-1641. That's 832-598-1641. If you can't get through, please let me know. We will make sure you get through. Right. Does this mean that he's still going to that they can still bring criminal charges once they complete the investigation and come to the easy conclusion that this was a murder, torture, all of the above, and a cover up? So after that, what? It's a civil investigation, so what's gonna happen? What y'all gonna do? What y'all gonna do? What are we gonna do? Change some laws or something? That's when I'm starting to get frustrated, right? Because I'm like, damn that. If it was enough to do this investigation, then where's the criminal? We gotta talk about where the hell is the criminal investigation. Huh? You tune in to the Black People's Podcast. Feel free to call in. The number is 832-598-1641. The number is 832-598-1641. Y'all know how I go. Huh? I'm gonna move to the next topic here shortly. Sway Z TV, I need you on deck. Sway Z TV, I need you on deck. Salute. Matter of fact, let me find this out myself. I'll do the work. Let me find this out, because now I want to know before I move on. Before I move on, you know, I don't claim to be the smartest man out here, but I want to know, can a civil investigation lead to criminal charges? That's all I want to know, because if it can't, you could miss me with the oop-de-wop. That's what I'm saying. Says right here, yes, a civil case can turn criminal in the respect that the evidence uncovered in a civil case can prompt a criminal investigation. When a civil trial reveals information that one of the parties may have committed a crime. See, I think that's backwards. I think what's going on here is ass backwards.
To accept, press 1. To send a voicemail, press 2.
You tuned in. You tuned in to the Black People's Podcast. What's your name? Where you calling from?
Peace, 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 bro. It's your boy Swazi.
All right, what's Jersey. Up, Swazi? How you doing?
What's going on?
Jersey,
I'm doing.
Jersey in the building, y'all. Jersey in the building. Hey, make sure y'all sharing behind the scenes. Talk to us, man. Have you been tuned in? Are you watching? Are you up with this Ronald Green situation?
Yeah, I heard about it before and was paying attention, and you kind of go through things. And I know you were asking the question, is the civil trial
right
connected to the criminal trial? Normally, those are two separate proceedings. But what struck me, and listen, I don't want to ignore our brother's death, because most importantly, that right there, like you said, we got to figure something out with this. But like you said, you did point something out. The confession was a bit odd. And the untimely murder of the detective is a bit odd. The detective.
Talk about that. Talk about that. Cause you know that went over my head too. They said that one of the detectives, one of these people on the scene, since then has died in a mysterious car. Correct? Can you speak to that?
Yeah. Well, let me. Yeah, definitely. I pulled up a quick thing. Master Trooper Chris Collinsworth.
Go ahead.
Had been placed on paid leave September 9th amid growing fallout, including state and federal investigations from the May 2019 death of Ronald Green following a high-speed chase near Monroe. So this was in myarclamiss.com. So from what I'm seeing, this is very odd, bro.
Right.
It feels like they're just going to pin it all on Chris Collinsworth. That's why there's no need for a criminal investigation. I'm not digging deep enough. I haven't dig deep enough, Brad, so... And, you know, somebody could come up behind me and tell me more information possibly, but just my logical mind leads me in a direction like Mr. Hollinsworth and his family has paid the ultimate sacrifice for this entire event.
Yo,
so
that's deep. That's deep.
Yeah, the money
that's
is
deep.
Nothing. You that know, went, the money is head. Nothing for them.
Right.
The money is nothing for them, Brad, because for them to pay out the family, it's absolutely nothing. And let's be honest, this is a part of their objective, man. This is a part of their objective. This is what I put in the chat. It's a part of their objective. If you're becoming an officer and you're fully aware of all the things that have transpired within this country, and you're walking in that same direction, you know what you're a part of. You know? We can't keep giving them a pass, right? You know, we don't give somebody a pass for making bad decisions any other time. We always hold people accountable in society. Why is it okay for cops to say, oh, well, you know, it's okay because another cop is there or I'm not really hurting anybody because it's a criminal. You know, right. It's us versus them, that mentality. When anyone in the eyes of the law can be a criminal for a moment, especially in a, you know, you can have a situation anywhere. So this is why I'm not, I don't like that whole situation. And that brother Green, that looked like a very nice looking gentleman. Like that man's life cut short. Come on, y'all.
Okay, now let me clarify. I found a little something right here. It says that because it's a difference. But we're talking about they're doing a civil rights investigation, right? Not like a civil trial. Like for it's called a civil rights investigation, right? I'm asking where's the criminal investigation? It says right here though that. Subject to the general principles contained herein, either the Civil Rights Division or the United States Attorney's Office may investigate and prosecute on its own any type of criminal civil rights violation. So it sounds like they taking this over because nobody else, they so busy trying to cover it up that they won't bring the criminal charges. So the federal government had to. Does that make sense?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Come on, it's 2019.
Right, right.
2019. We're basically two years away from that situation. Why there have been no charges brought up? That makes zero sense, man.
Yeah, we know
because
what's going on.
In my opinion, those charges are in the 6 feet deep with Collinsworth, whatever his name is.
Now, I want to say this. I want to ask you this before I let you go because we're working on something behind the scenes, but we want to start preparing the people, okay? So we're going to keep it very, very, very simple, okay? So you do work in the stocks and trade industry, correct?
No, and yes.
Okay, so
I'm a project IT project manager. Okay, so I deal with project management, but as a hobby, I deal with stocks and I teach other people how to trade and invest as well.
Okay, now y'all pay attention. We about to talk money real quick. All right, we're finna talk money now. I want to focus on you as far as investing into the stock market. Okay, and so what I'm gonna try to do here on the Black People's Podcast, I'm gonna encourage everybody, especially in the Bread Gang, to just start a simple account. You feel me? Where we can all kind of chop this stuff up. You feel me? And kind of help each other out as far as starting to trade a little bit. Okay, so. This is the question I want to ask you. If I'm a new person getting into the stock industry, I want to trade a little bit, right? But I'm thinking, yo, I don't have enough money, right? I can't even afford one stock, or I don't have, this. You feel me? I can't get this. Can you explain to the people the basics of right now of what you need to be able to trade a stock, and to you, what are those? What are the best basic tools to use, right, as far as the apps and stuff like that that we should start looking at?
All right, sure, bro. And good question. So the basic right now, you have the ability as a new investor to open up an account with pretty much any broker out there, from TD Ameritrade to Robinhood to Webull. Now, what you're going to notice with these different platforms is what varies is the complexities. So if you're a new investor, I would steer you to a platform that's a little more, they give more explanations as you go through your trading. So, for example, you would have Robinhood is pretty good. Webull is pretty good. Now, people are kind of like, there's like an uproar against Robinhood in the trading world. So a lot of people are staring clear of Robinhood because I know you guys all heard about Wall Street Bets and GameStop. So if you don't mind being in something that you don't really agree with, then Robinhood. But personally, I'm saying Webull because I'm not really feeling Robinhood right now. Now, when it comes to tools, the tools that you need are basically charts, trend knowledge, and a little bit of capital. And you don't need much money, Brad. You have the ability right now to invest as little as $1 in any stock in the market. It's called fractional investing. You don't have to buy the entire stock. You can buy a small portion, and you can take advantage as the stock grows. So you can continue to buy more and build up your position. You have a lot of different options. The most important thing you can do for yourself right now is what I'm trying to get across to my people first. In order to invest in the stock market, you have to be used to paying yourself. You got to pay yourself first. And by paying yourself first, that means when you get paid, you have to say, okay, I know that I want to apply 10% of this to, I want 10% of my income. I want to take 5% and put it into my 50% and put it into my savings, and 50% and put into my investing account. And by you doing that, you start to build a habit. Because the most important thing you can do in the market is build liquidity. You want money. You want to have the ability to hop on the next play. And if you don't have any money, you can't make a move. So if you get accustomed to doing that, just a small amount, my people, just go. And I'm sorry if I don't have the article in front of me right now, but if you research in Google and just look up the cup of coffee a day, basically is just, if you were to save that money every day and just put it into a savings account, how much money you would accumulate. It's a lot of money, guys. Just that alone. Okay. Just saving. So investing is what ramps it up and gives you the ability for freedom, because just saving is going to be a little bit, you have enough to sit back and relax. Investing changes lives. Simple as that.
All right, man. Sway, I appreciate you. I'm going to continue to talk to you behind the scenes. It's going to be called With a Bread at y'all. So y'all pick up them little breadcrumbs right there. We're going to continue, to build on that. Let me see if I can find you. I'm pinning him. right now, make sure y'all follow him, right? Make sure y'all follow him on YouTube. And can you tell them where they can find you? What's your thing on Instagram?
On IG?
Yeah.
IG on Instagram, I'm Swazee TV, Swazee TV. On YouTube, Swazee TV as well. You can find me on Twitter. I'm doing a 4K to $40,000 challenge, basically taking a $4,000 account to 40K by the end of the year, hopefully. You can follow that on Twitter under SilverSurf19. And otherwise, tap in with me. I'm willing to help my people. So, and I'm not looking for much. I'm just looking for more eyes on the market. And by making you guys better, it improves me as well. So keep that in mind as you reach out.
That's what we're doing, y'all. Hey, man, we appreciate you. We appreciate you. Hold it down.
All right, you too, bro. Appreciate the opportunity, brother.
I appreciate your call. All right, this is what we're doing at the Black People's Podcast, y'all. This is what we're doing at the Black People's Podcast. I told y'all we was coming back hard. I told y'all we was coming back hard, right? I got to get that man a round of applause for that call, man. I got to get that man a round of applause. And again, what I got out of it is the big boys had to come in and do this investigation because these people would not bring charges. Right, and then I also want to say, let me see. I think I got one back there. Okay, now we're good. Okay, let's keep it going. Now, I want to take this time, man. I got a special announcement. We have a birthday, right? We got a birthday in the house, right? So we're gonna let me take my head out. We're gonna take our time and go through this, right. And I'm gonna see if it's gonna work. Let me see if I can get her up. And I'm gonna be respectful as I can. But one of my main contributors, it's her birthday today. Salute to Black Jade. That's Black Jade in the chat. Right, let's give her a round of applause. It's her birthday. It's her birthday, right? And so, I have to do this. We have to play a birthday song for her, right? She been down with me. She been down with me for since day one, right? She keep the comments under control, right? She's always giving me constructive criticism, whether it was good or it was bad. That's very, very important. You feel me? To have somebody tell you both sides, right? Salute to Black Jade for that. You understand? And so, let me see. We're gonna go ahead and play our birthday song, man. You feel me? And, you know, we gotta go old school with it. We have to go old school with it. So let's go, man. You tune in to the Black People's Podcast, and this is for Black Jay. Let's go. And Black Jay, can you please put your Cash App in the comment, please. This is for Black Jay, y'all. Happy birthday, Queen. song, ma.
Who know the way true?
You get the whole song.
It's love and unity to all of God's children. But you be afraid, bitch. And the whole day should be spent in poor remembrance of those who lived and died for the oneness of our people.
Salute, man. Salute, salute, salute. Salute to the queen, man. I appreciate all your support. And you know, when I was thinking today, and I don't give a damn. I don't give a damn about the file. I don't give a damn about the view. I don't give a damn about none of that. Let me handle my business. When I was thinking about you know, your birthday and everything today, right? This is a page. Make sure y'all follow Black J right now. Make sure y'all follow Black J right now. This is her Instagram page. I'm not gonna show her face and all that. This is her Instagram page. And let me show you why. Because this is what I should have been doing, and this is what I'm finna start doing from now on. Right? Because she is an official contributor. She's an official sponsor, and she has a black business. I'm gonna say that again. She has her own black business. Right? So I have to apologize because I could have been and should have been promoting Black J's craft and her business every goddamn episode. That's on bread, but we gonna get it right. Let me make sure we can see. Can y'all see? Talk to me in the chat. Let me make sure y'all can see. Support your black business, ladies and gentlemen. Support your black business, ladies and gentlemen. Let me pin her right now. That's Black Jade in the pin, right? And so what we're gonna do, we're gonna take a little time and we're gonna go to her website. And we're gonna purchase right here, because I was looking at some stuff, right? So again, she has the crochet. Right? Matter of fact, let me get the big body. Let me do this big body style. Don't worry about me. Right? There we go. Let's do this big body style. This is her page, right? Right? Crochet Lovely by _D. Okay? Once you go to her page, you can click right here and you can go to her business. It's gonna take you right to her business. Crochet Love by D. That's Crochet Love by D. Support your black business. Now, I was looking at some of these earlier. She could do anything with crochet, right? And I was just thinking, they're like, yo, I really out there. My girl loves this crochet stuff, right? And then we really out here, you feel me? And it'd be really cold. It'd be really cool out here. She got the jewelry, right? Look, she got the jewelry on here. See? Look at that. She got the jewelry. Look at them earrings. Huh? She got something for everybody on here. She got the bracelets. Y'all go support right now, because I'm finna buy something right now, live. I'm finna pick what I want, and I'm finna buy something right now live. I need somebody to join me. Tonight we support black business. Happy birthday to Black Jade. Happy birthday to Black Jade. And I'm gonna bust this down and make this a little commercial within itself. I'm liking these earrings, and I'm liking these hats, these Scullies. Right? Go give her that like 50s look. I see what you're doing. I like these little tops, but she gonna have to talk to you about her size though. So we gonna keep it simple. I'm gonna go right here. She got free shipping for some of her items, she got free shipping. Let me see if I can find one I want that got free shipping. You know me, I got to find the deal already. I'm going to be cheap online. I'm sorry. I'm looking for the free shipping, but it's okay. I like these earrings right here. I like these right here. We finna buy these right here. Look at the earrings I finna get. Let me show y'all one more time. Salute to Black J, man. Salute to Black J. I finna buy these earrings right here. What y'all think? Support your black business, man. Support your black business. Right? $25. This order is a gift. Prices will not be shown. Yeah, I don't want to show no. All right, there we go. Right there, Visa, MasterCard. Proceed to checkout. Right? Matter of fact, let me do it with this. Might let me pay straight with PayPal. Let's see. Boom. Let's see. There we go. Continue. Let me turn this off. I don't want none of my passwords showing while I put my information in. Hold up, y'all. You tune in to the Black People's Podcast with Bread Man. Right now, I'm supporting my black businesses. I'm supporting my black businesses. Right? Let me fill this out, and then I'll put my receipt up. I need somebody to participate with me. You feel me? You tune in to the Black People's Podcast of Bread, man. Make sure you hit like, make sure you hit share, and make sure you hit subscribe. This feels good. Supporting black business. Right? Make sure y'all follow her right now. 02908. Bam. Rhode Island. Matter of fact, let me put some music on. I do apologize. No, I don't. But let me put some music on real quick. Never mind, we good. Let me see. No. I sent it to the wrong address. God dog it. I'll be able to fix it. Oh, shit. Let me see. How can I? I got to go back to fix that. Let me see. Bam, 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 bam. I'll go back and fix that. But here go my thing right here, y'all. Check your thing, Black J. I sent it to the wrong address, but I'm going to fix it. Let me see if I go to my email. Is my receipt there? Make sure you support your black businesses. Here we go right here. Let me get back up. Make sure you support your black businesses. I got you, Black Jade. Let me get this down. Where we at? Dang it, it's too much up. Here we go. I got you right there. Order is confirmed. I just got to fix my address. I appreciate your support. Huh? I appreciate your support. I just gotta fix the address. I get with you back there behind the scenes. That's my fault. I was in a rush. Put my old address in there. You tuned in to the Black People's Podcast, man. You tuned in to the Black People's Podcast of Bread, man. This is what we do, man. We gotta support each other, right? We gotta look after our own, man. That's truly one of our own, right? We've been talking about Ronald Green. We're about to move on to the next topic. I wanna play some music here, get myself together behind the scenes. Take a little small break, get myself together behind the scenes, get some libation, get something to drink and try to get these numbers back up. Right? You tune in to the Black People's Podcast with Bread, man. Make sure you hit like, make sure you hit share, and make sure you hit subscribe. Help me get these numbers up. Let's go. Let's go. Oh my goodness, where's this other music coming from? What is that? What is that? Okay, you get out of here. My apologies, y'all. Let's go.
Can you dig it?
Juice.
Can you dig it?
Juice. Juice. Blacker the berry, the sweeter the juice. You got that, you got that juice. You got that, you got that juice. You got that, you got that juice. You got that, you got that, you got that power. Yeah, power to the people. Yeah, all power to the people. Yeah, the power's in the people. In the streets mobbing, ripping good over evil. Look, power, power to the people. Yeah, all power to the people. In the people, burning and looting, ripping good over evil. Look, look, the power's in the people. Should've asked for equity, but we'd rather be equal. Let my people go, Prince of Egypt, this the sequel. Could never give up the pressures, watch them burn just like Smeagol. It's the Ock, giving life like an Ankh. We went from Chaldea, but ended on Plymouth Rock. We went from Black Tulsa to Section 8 out and watch. Judas in the Black Messiah, them crackers, they want me shot. That's the truth too, Black man magic, I might hit they ass with voodoo. Took the Bible, but left the land, Desmond Tutu. We only blind black at this point, go grab your who's who. I rep that north side till I die, and that's a Blues Clue. Look, I ain't never want the recognition. All praises due, man. We in full submission. Now that I got your attention, you should know you got that juice too. Non-GMO, please don't let them people fool you. Power, yeah. Power to the people. Yeah. All power to the people. Yeah. The power's in the people. In the streets mobbing, ripping good over evil. Look, power, power to the people.
Get the numbers up. Get these numbers up. You tune in. You tune in to the Black People's Podcast with Bread, man. Let's go.
Burning and looting, repping good over evil. Look.
You got the, you got the, you got the
juice.
You're tuned in. You tune in to the Black People's. You tune in to the Black People's Podcast with Bread, man. Make sure you hit like, make sure you hit share, and make sure you hit subscribe. Make sure you hit like, make sure you hit like, make sure you hit share, make sure you hit subscribe. Right? If you got your kids up watching, I'm gonna need you to put your babies up because it's gonna get a little bit more sinister as the show goes on. Because I told y'all I'm putting Pornhub on trial. I know it sounds crazy. I need y'all to just stay there. Just stay there and bear with me. Right? Just bear with me. I'm not ready to get to it just yet. It's probably going to have to be the last topic because I want to make sure that the live don't get shut down. I gotta make sure the live don't get shut down. Damn. I cannot, I don't know where, I'm sorry, y'all. Excuse me. Get all that down. You tune in to the Black People's Podcast with Bread, man. Make sure you like, make sure you share, make sure you subscribe. Can y'all hear me? Are we still good? Y'all let me know if we still good. We're gonna keep it going. Dang, I hope I ain't mess up nothing. We're gonna keep it going. I had so much shit up. I had to get some of this stuff down. Make sure we still good. Make sure y'all sharing, man. Make sure y'all sharing. Salute to the new subscribers. Salute to the new subscribers. I appreciate that. That's what I'm talking about. I appreciate that. That's what I'm talking about. Oh yeah, we still good. We still good. Salute to the new subscribers. What else did I have on deck? Let me see. Again, as I'm saying, it's gonna get a lot more sinister. It's gonna get a lot more sinister before the end of the night. Make sure y'all get the likes up. Make sure y'all hitting the likes. Right? I want to cover. I want to cover the young man who had the, let me see if I can get him up. Let me see if I can get him up. Right there. No, that's Pornhub. I wanted to talk about the young man who had his daughters in his ashes, the urn. Right? The police. But I think I'm gonna upload that. I'm gonna upload that one. That'll be an upload. I want to talk about Andrew Brown. They released the video. Right? They did release the video, and I haven't even watched it. I'm gonna be honest. I hadn't even watched it because it didn't matter to me. This is the same thing. Huh? This is the same thing that we just watched. Okay? Let me see if I can get it up. Here we go. I haven't even watched this yet. We're talking about Andrew Brown when they served this death warrant. When they showed up to his home and they served this death warrant. Right? They showed up to his home and they served this death warrant. So now we got the salute. Salute to Black Jade. I appreciate your support. Again, I appreciate your donation. That's what we do. That's how we support each other. I appreciate that, Black Jade. Good looking out.
Shit like that.
Good looking out.
Thank you.
I appreciate your donation. Right? But Andrew Brown, we're talking about the death warrant that they showed up with. These are what these are called now. I don't even call them arrest warrants no more. These are death warrants. That's why I'm coming out. I promise you. Y'all, they're going to think it's funny, but it's going to be so for real when I start coming out with these classes and this basic curriculum on just to how to survive and extend your life as a Black man. That's really what I'm about to be on, because real talk, it's not, when you get an arrest warrant, my G, that's a death warrant, my G. That's a death warrant. So here we covered Andrew Brown, right? How they showed up to his home with a search warrant, and he decided to leave. Non-violent crime. He decided to leave. Search the house. Do what you want. And they gunned him down. They fought in order to not release the video. Now the video is released. So we're gonna bust it down right here at the Black People's Podcast. This is what we do. It's one of the hardest parts of what we do here. Right? But we have to document. We gotta keep the record straight. Right? We have to take control of our own narrative. We can't let them create our narrative for us. So let's check out the video and see what happened. Let's go. You tuned into the Black
Andrew
News
Brown
podcast.
Was shot by sheriff's deputies who are executing a search and arrest warrant on him in Elizabeth City, North Carolina. The local prosecutor there out detailing, he says this shooting was justified because Andrew Brown tried to flee the scene in a car that he determined was a threat to the officers. Therefore, they had the right to use deadly force against him. We're going to show you in just a moment some of the body camera footage released at this press conference. I just want to quickly go through some of the other headlines. The district attorney saying he did not tell the Brown family before he had this announcement today that he was going to do this. He says there's some dysfunction in the relationship between the prosecutor's office and the Brown family and the attorneys. At one point accusing some of the attorneys working with the Brown family of misrepresenting facts in this case. The prosecutor also saying that the body camera footage he did show at the press briefing will now not be made public. If media organizations or anyone else wants that footage, they must go to the courts and ask for it. So we do not know. I'm about to show you about a minute-long clip of that body camera footage. I just want to make clear, this was released by the prosecutor. We are not certain of its context, its full context. It does show some of the fatal encounter between sheriff's deputies. It shows officers approaching Mr. Brown's car, shouting, "Stop!" The car then starts to drive away, and the officers begin to fire. We're going to show you this. It's just shy of a minute. Just want to caution you, some of what you're about to see is quite graphic.
So, do y'all remember? Yo, y'all think I be talking crazy, right? Y'all want to say Breadman be bugging, don't you? I know, don't you? But did I not just tell y'all 30 minutes earlier? Did I not just tell y'all 30 minutes earlier how they be riding out to lynch people, right? How it's no difference because, right? Because they don't have, because they, you think because they don't have knickerbockers on, that it's still not the same thing? You think because they not in a 1950 pickup truck riding out with a burning cross on the back, that it's not the same thing? See, a lot of people would think that was controversial, that, oh, bro, you're reaching. But here we are. And this is exactly how they pulled up to this man's house. Huh? In a pickup truck, riding on the back. Good old boy shit, right? My nigga, where can you do this at? Where do they do this at? That's all I wanna know. Let's go. These people are killers.
Let's bring into our conversation to share their...
These people are trained killers, bro. Nothing else. They're not. Yo, my G, let me tell you something. They was there to serve a search warrant for drugs. They showed up like they was going to Bin Laden house, my G. That's why I didn't want to watch this. They knew what time it was as soon as they was right here riding out in this truck, in this ragged-ass pickup. Right? They was getting in the character. Do you understand what I'm saying? And as soon as they pulled up, he's leaving. He's already leaving. I told you what they was going to try to say. Oh, he used his vehicle as a weapon. We're going to watch this one more time. I'm coming out with curriculum to protect us, bro. Real talk. Go. They all right there in front of his car, and he's bagging up. He's leaving. He's leaving. And so my question is right here. My question is, real talk, this is my question. How they know who this is? For all they know, that's just a black man in a car leaving. How they know who this man is in order to start using deadly force like that? It didn't matter. It didn't matter because he was one of us. This is what we're dealing with in Black America. This is what we're dealing with in Black America. And me personally, I'm tired, right? I'm tired. I'm tired of giving these people alley hoops. You feel me? I know what we got to do. So if we got to do it, we got to be smarter. We got to be extra smart, bro. Extra, extra smart. I went in last time. I'm not going to go in from that aspect. I'm talking about all these cases. I knew they was going to try to say, he drove towards us. My life was in danger. I knew that. But again, we just watched another unarmed. They didn't find no guns. They didn't find no drugs in the car. More facts. There was no drugs, and there was no guns found in this man's car. You tell me why this man deserved to die. Why was it was so important to fire upon this car that was leaving when y'all was just supposed to be showing up searching the house for dope? You want us dead, you want us gone so bad. You want us dead and gone so bad. I know what it is. You showed up to serve a death warrant. Bottom line. The phone lines are still open. 832-598-1641. 832-598-1641. Right? Anybody can call in, get it off your chest. It's all good. This is an open platform. Jay, can you please share the number for him? It's an open platform. Okay? Everybody is welcome. Get the numbers up. Get the numbers up. Make sure we're sharing. Get the numbers up and make sure we're sharing. I'm going to change this picture in the title because now things are going to get a little bit more sinister. And I'm going to try to talk about this subject without even cussing. And I'm going to try to be very, very particular about how I'm saying it. Right? Because I don't want to get our lives shut down. You understand? But we talk about all topics here at the Black People's Podcast. We talk about all topics here at the Black People's Podcast. So I was having, and I've been having a debate, right? It's a hood debate, yes, but it's a debate nonetheless. About sex workers, right? About particularly African or African American sex workers in the African American sex industry. Well, not African American sex in the porn industry and underground sex worker world. Would you say? Right. Very, 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 very taboo topic. Matter of fact, let me cut these lights off. It's a very, very, very taboo. It's a very, very taboo topic. Phone lines are open as well. 832-598-1641. 832-598-1641. right? And so this is going to be interesting. And so what I've noticed about this particular field, and the reason I'm putting Pornhub particularly on trial tonight, because they are one of the leading distributors when we talk about pornography. Correct? If some of y'all, if so, is this going over some of y'all head? Look. Tap out, you know what I'm saying? Or you could tune in. It don't make me done. Right? I feel like everyone has watched a little porn, you know, here and there. It's a very, very, very taboo topic. You know, I ain't scared to talk about nothing here at the Black People's Podcast. So, as I was saying, it is a very, very taboo topic. But when we talking about, and I want to talk about it from the streets all the way to the top. But I'm putting Pornhub on trial because they're one of the main distributors when we're talking about pornography. There is a lot of amateur, and this is what I'm talking about, because I believe that this is amateur content that I have a problem with. There's a lot of amateur content on Pornhub. Right? And so let me just get to it. My main problem with this content and what it has to do with the African-American community is what I noticed is there is a lot of what we would call it hate porn. There's a lot of hate porn on the internet, and it seems like most of and all of the hate porn involves the African American female. I'm gonna say that again. There's a lot of hate porn on the internet. Yes, that's the name I'm giving it. I believe it's a genre. I'm not talking about dominatrix and BDSM and stuff like that. No. This is a whole different level. It's literally, you know, you're a hate crime. This is hate porn. Right? Pornhub is a very major distributor of it. And it consists of females, right? In sexual, in your routine sexual activities, a lot of them extremely provocative, females and men. But these are to the max because it adds a certain racial texture to it. You may see white men, right, in a typical gangbang, which is not, that's not out of the realm when we're talking about porn. When you go to a porn site, it's not out of the realm to see these type of things. You know, several men, just for people who don't know what a gangbang is, this is several men being with one woman, you know, or, you know, several women being with one man, vice versa. But it's not out the norm. They have a whole genre for this, right? But it turns into hate porn when you see that all those men are white and it's one black woman, and all those men have on Confederate flag t-shirts. Ladies and gentlemen, this is hate porn. It gets extremely more sinister if I broke down the particulars of how far this goes. My YouTube page might just get shut down. Right? And so what I'm saying is this hate porn genre, I don't know how far this goes back. I really don't. I just know it messes up my day, because I confess, I do watch porn from time to time. Right? And nothing pains me more when I'm just skimming through trying to find something, and these vulgar titles and these vulgar pictures come up of hate porn, black women being defiled by white men in Confederate flag t-shirts. That's just one example. That's just one example. So I want to know, first of all, who's producing this? Look, it's to the point to where I want to put out I want to file a lawsuit against some of the images, because you know some of that stuff is already, they already have it playing, right, as you're going through, you know, with the words and everything. I'm to the point I'm traumatized. I want to file a lawsuit against some of this defiling, deviant, nasty stuff that I've seen. Right? So that's why I'm going at Pornhub. I'm putting them on trial because I want to know. Because again, this only works one way. There's not any type of material where it works. The other way. There are not multiple men out here in Confederate flag t-shirts. It doesn't even work like that. Ladies and gentlemen, this is hate porn. I want to know how producing such material is not a hate crime. I see y'all quiet. I see y'all extra quiet in the comments. It's okay. I could bring this one home. I know. Right? It's deep and it's nasty. Now, you might say, Brad, why are you even worried? Why are you worried about this type of stuff? Why would you? You must be, no, it's not like that. See, what I know is, what I know is 90% of people watch porn. What I also know is that this content is being delivered to a specific genre. What I also know is obviously we have people who look like me and talk like me that are participating and creating these activities. What I also know is, as a person who comes from the streets, right, has very in-depth knowledge about how that world works, a lot of our sisters, a lot of our queens, right, are being treated like this every day behind closed doors, and we don't even know. So that's why I'm going in on it. Cause not only is it happening, it's being promoted, and money is being made off of it. Oh, Brad, man, it's their business. They should be able to do what they want to do. They should be able. What if that was your daughter, though? Huh? What if that was your niece or your sister, though? Huh? And see, what we really fell in the midst is this is the gutter, the bottom, right, of the the generic shit that we see every day. But down here, this the foundation of this shit. Nobody want to get down here and talk about it. If they're able to keep this nasty type of shit alive, then that's why we got, this is what another main reason why we'll always have a problem. Because apparently, there's a large population who love to see black people Still See, because again, this is nothing new. They used to come on. They used to come on at the church and do all kind of sinister stuff. That they used to do all kind of. Go watch the Underground Railroad right now. In North Carolina, they used to kill us as a ritual publicly at church. Just during church, y'all. Huh? They used to keep us around and do all kind of sadistic shit before work, right? Late night before they, right? So what I'm saying is this has never stopped. There's always been an arena for this. They've always been protected. And I'm saying, when will it stop? So I was interested to see what the Bread Gang thought about this, if anything, but y'all seem to be very, very quiet. Very, very quiet on this topic, I understand. I understand. So I'll talk about it for us. Right? Yo, certain things should not exist, my G, period. Period. Because these nasty white boys are getting off on this material and then picking up their gun in their holster and going to work. You see, sexual deviancy goes extremely deep, my friend. Deviant behavior goes extremely deep, my friend. People with deviant behavior should not be working on a constant basis around people with guns. But I would ask you, how many people, what do they call it? Internet and cookies, do they go through? No, they don't do that. That's not a requirement. They say you could do what you want. No, you can't. They're not venting these officers, these people. What I'm saying is there's an overlay of this sadistic behavior. I hope it's not going over y'all head tonight. There's an overlay of this sadistic behavior. We got to call it out at every turn. There's a heavy overlay of the sadistic behavior. I want to see the receipts. I want to go into these people's private lives that's killing us every day. Huh? We know Derek Chauvin, he had a, I'm not trying to be racist. Didn't he have an Asian wife? She divorced him doing all this. He had a good old Asian wife, right? Salute. I want to know. There's a sadistic overlay to what's going on here. And nobody want to talk about it, because if we did, none of their asses will be working. That's all I'm saying. That's all I'm saying. But when you apply for a job, right, ain't they all in your mix? Isn't everything on the table? You tuned in to the Black People's Podcast of Bread Man. Make sure you hit like, make sure you hit share, make sure you hit subscribe. Huh? They'll put you under the microscope. They let these people come out, unvented, take lives, and still don't go through that shit. I'm just saying. We have to try to put the Legos together, man. We got to put the pieces together and see what's going on here. Black Jay says, this is a touchy subject. Yeah, I'm going, you know, this is what it's all about. I'm gonna go where no man has gone before. I'm almost positive. Right? I'm gonna draw that conclusion. That if you put these people under a microscope, right, that are torturing unarmed black people, I guarantee you that hate porn is in the mix. Huh? I can almost guarantee you that the hate porn, that hate, that nasty ass hate porn, that's in their repertoire. Huh? That's all I'm saying. You tuned in to the Black People's Podcast with Bread Man. Make sure you hit like, make sure you hit share, make sure you hit subscribe. I think I got time for one more. I think I got time to get one more topic in. I know. Y'all come on back out the dark now. Y'all come on back out the closet now. We good. I put the blinky away. Nah, but on the cool, I think I do have time for one more topic. This one pretty much pissed me off. That's why I was going to hold off on it. But let's go ahead and cover this topic, man. Right? The police, right? They throw this black man's daughter, her ashes out, talking about they thought that it was drugs. Now, I watched the video. And what bothered me is, number one, they knew this man. They knew the young man. They're trying to say that they mistook. Police mistook. Let me get the video up. You tune into the Black People's Podcast of Bread Man. Make sure you hit like, make sure you hit share, make sure you hit subscribe. Yeah, so what happens, y'all? Young black man getting arrested, having another issue with the police. Right? We have another encounter with the police. Young black man. Right? They throw. The young black man keeps his daughter's ashes on him. He keeps his daughter pads. It's a young black man. His baby girl died, right? And he keeps his baby girl's ashes on him. Now, this is not uncommon for anybody who think that this might be, this is not uncommon. Okay, if you can see the picture now, you see it's a very seems like a very expensive, that looks like gold. It has designs on it. Right? This is not uncommon. These boys finna act like they didn't know what this was. This is not an uncommon practice for people to keep the ashes of their loved ones with them. Let's watch the video. You tune into the Black People's Podcast with Bread Man. Let's go.
My name is Lori Arnold. The money I make a week, I used to make that in a few minutes.
You tune into the Black People's Podcast with Bread Man. Yeah, y'all come on out now, man. We here. Y'all come on out. We back. they weren't ready for that topic. I see. It's okay. It's okay. Make sure y'all hit the like and make sure y'all sharing, man. Get the likes up and make sure y'all sharing. Get the likes up, make sure you sharing.
Word. A little bit of like X crushed up.
X crushed up, word.
Center console.
You sure it's S, bro?
It's like Molly or Ecstasy crushed up.
No, try. Y'all did some tests on it, bro?
Yeah, it tested positive for meth / MDMA.
What?
Yeah.
You sure, bro?
I'll show it to you.
Yeah.
Now see, this the oopty wop. Oh, I gotta go back. Yo, these motherfuckers should go to jail for what they did. I'm sorry, I'm cussing now. They need to go to jail for what they did. Pay attention to what's going on. They're trying to hit this black man with the oopty wop and make him incriminate himself. That's why we shouldn't even be talking to these people. We shouldn't even be talking to these people because they all filled with fucking lies. They just want to put you in jail or kill you, yo. That would like be the ultimate goal, right? Anything under that, you know what I'm saying? As long as they take you away somewhere, but that would be the ultimate. That's the ultimate. Look, they walk up to the man car lying.
Man, there was something else in the car too.
What?
A little bit of like X crushed up.
X crushed up, where?
Center console.
You sure it's X, bro?
It's like Molly or Ecstasy crushed up.
No, try. Y'all did some tests on it, bro?
Yeah, it tested positive for meth / MDMA.
What?
Yeah.
You sure, bro?
I'll show it to you.
Yeah.
Plus the weed, man, is too much, you know what I'm saying?
Plus the weed, shut up.
No, you got too much weed anyways, and it's got to be, like, in different packaging. It's got to be, like, child-resistant, odor-proof.
No, bro, that's my daughter. What are y'all doing, bro? That's my daughter, bro. Give me that, bro. That's my daughter, okay. Bro. That's my daughter. What are y'all doing? No. Ask my daddy, bro. That's my daughter in there.
I will.
What are y'all doing? Don't you know, bro? Y'all can't. Whoa, bro. That's my. Wow, she just passed 2 years. She just passed last year. You know me, bro. Yeah. That's her, bro.
Okay.
No, bro.
Let me talk to the officer.
Please give me my daughter, bro. Put her in my hand, bro. Y'all are disrespectful, bro.
You need to move your arm.
Okay, bro. Can I please have my daughter?
What the fuck?
Tell my dad to calm down, bro.
I'm going to give it to your dad,
all right? Yeah, tell him to calm down, bro. Yeah, bro. Thank you, bro.
Hey, sir. So the test kit, like, it did look like it feels.
He's lying.
Bro, I knew that was impossible.
He's lying. The officer is lying.
That was my character, bro. That's my daughter, bro.
I got you. I believe you, man. I'm going to give it to your dad if you're cool with that,
right? Thank you, bro. Thank you so much.
What do we just watch? Are you serious? Do you understand? Let me tell y'all. Yo. Didn't I tell y'all? Itching. So he really don't even have a case. They're not locking niggas up for weed no more. He had like two zips. You can have 2 ounces on you. That's a fact. Oh, it got to be in child zip. It got to be in. Give me my ticket. Let me go. What you talking about? But you trying to work. You trying to work me with the oopty-wop. Huh? You trying to work me with the oopty-wop, trying to get me to self-incriminate myself on some dumb shit that ain't even true. Then you come back and you got my daughter in your hand. Yo, this is sick, man. This is sick. This would be a jail for this. This would be a charge for this too, bro. You can't be lying on a job like that. You can't do that.
What?
A little bit of like X crushed up.
X crushed up. What?
Center console.
You sure it's X, bro?
It's like Molly or Ecstasy crushed up.
No, try. Y'all did some tests on it, bro?
Yeah, it tested positive for meth / MDMA.
What?
Now, unless that's true, that man need to be fired, he need to be charged, and they need a civil suit on his ass.
Yeah.
You sure, bro?
I'll show it to you.
Yeah.
That's whack, bro. That's so whack.
Well, plus the weed, man, is too much, you know what I'm saying?
No, it's not.
No, you got too much weed anyway.
It's 2 ounces.
Plus the weed, man, is too much, you know what I'm saying?
He hustling.
No, you got too much weed anyways, and it's got to be, like, in different packaging. It's got to be, like, child-resistant, odor-proof.
No, bro, that's my daughter. What are y'all doing, bro? That's my daughter, bro. Give me that, bro. That's my daughter, okay. Bro. That's my daughter. What are y'all doing? No. Ask my daddy, bro. That's my daughter in there.
I will.
What are y'all doing? Don't you know, bro? Y'all can't. What? Whoa, bro. That's my. She just passed 2 years. She just passed last year. You know my. Yeah, you know me, bro. Yeah. That's her, bro.
Okay.
No, bro.
Let me talk to the officer.
Please give me my daughter, bro. Put her in my hand, bro. Y'all are disrespectful, bro.
You need to move your arm.
Bro. Can I please have my daughter?
Apparently, this is the daughter's ashes.
And look, man, let me tell you the craziest part about this. He was like, y'all know me. I be like, they don't care. He was like, y'all know me. They showing y'all that they don't care, bro. Not all police are the same. I agree. But at this point, is it worth your freedom? Is it worth your life? We got to figure out how to consistently protect ourselves. That's all I'm going to say. I'm going to do the work first. Y'all think I'm tripping. I'm going to do the work first. I'm going to do the work and I'm going to do the knowledge first. We have to figure out a way to increase our numbers to consistently protect ourselves when we come upon these people, you feel me, in a profession. When we come upon, you know what I'm saying, certain individuals in Walmart, you know, or in public, we gotta move a certain way to increase our chances, right, of not getting caught up with the bullshit. That's all I'm saying. You feel me? That was crazy. That broke my heart. That broke my heart. And he said, yo, y'all, you know me. You know my daughter. So you holding my daughter, bro. You feel me? Like, this how you treat me? I don't get no, you know what I mean? Like, what? You lying, carrying on? Talking about, yeah, we tested this, we did that. So they don't care. They don't care about you. They have no concern whatsoever. You're tuning into the Black People's Podcast. Make sure you hit like, make sure you hit share, make sure you hit subscribe. Yo, that was sick. On every level. Today's show was brought to you, was sponsored to you by Crochet. Crochet the Lovely. Let me make sure. No, Crochet Lovely by D. I do apologize. It was brought to you by Crochet Lovely by D. I purchased some beautiful earrings. Y'all make sure y'all go to her Instagram site. Make sure y'all go to her Instagram page. And make sure you pick yourself out something nice as well. You know, for you, for your loved one. Support your Black businesses. This is something we're going to be doing a lot more often. Right? So if you have something you want to promote, if you have something that you do yourself, let me know. Right? But we are going to be featuring Miss Jade definitely for the rest of the month, possibly for the next month to come. We will be featuring her business on our channel. You understand? You tuned in to the Black People's Podcast. Make sure you hit like. Make sure you share. Make sure you hit subscribe. The floor is open. Right? Anybody, feel free to call in. If you got something on your chest, feel free to call in. Right? I'm not a yes man, and I take all comers. I know sometimes my shit just be so thorough. You feel me? Y'all be like, damn, bro, you pretty much covered all bases, my G. I know. That's what I do. Salute to the chat. Salute to Black J. Salute to Pharaoh. Salute to Swayze TV. Right? Salute to Marcus. You got bodied. Right? The comments was light tonight. The comments was light. I need y'all more active in the comments, but salute. Huh? Salute. I gotta send you the address. Let me see my address on the email. I'll get with you behind the scenes, Black Jay, so I can see you. I gave you the wrong address, so my bad. I gotta fix that. I'm glad you can fix it. Thank you. Yeah, man, but that's pretty much our show tonight. I appreciate everybody tuning in. Definitely gotta play my track before we get up out of here, man. But that's our show for tonight, man. Don't nobody want to get on a jack. You feel me? Sometimes I keep it thorough like that. I understand. I have no quarrel. You feel me? But again, I appreciate everybody's support. Right? As y'all can see, we are back. I'll probably be coming to y'all a little bit later during the middle of the week or something like that. Be looking for me. I might give y'all a few uploads, right? I got some stuff in the tuck for y'all. But this is what we're doing. It's the Black People's Podcast of Bread Man, right? Before you get out of here, make sure you hit like, make sure you hit share, and make sure you hit subscribe. Appreciate the love. Love y'all back, man. Y'all hold it down. Huh?
Can you dig it? Can you dig it?
Juice. Juice, blacker the berry, the sweeter the juice. You got that, you got 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 that, you got that power. Yeah, power to the people. Yeah, all power to the people. Yeah, the power's in the people. In the streets mobbing, ripping good over evil. Look, power, power to the people. Power to the people, yeah. The power's in the people, burning and looting, repping good over evil. Look, the power's in the people. Shoulda asked for equity, but we'd rather be equal. Let my people go, Prince of Egypt, this the sequel. Could never give up the pressures, watch them burn just like Smeagol. It's the Ock, giving life like an Ankh. We went from Chaldea, but ended on Plymouth Rock. We went from Black Tulsa to Section 8 out and watch. Judas in the Black Messiah, them crackers, they want me shot. That's the truth too. Black man magic, I might hit they ass with voodoo. Took the Bible, but left the land. Desmond Tutu, we only blind black at this point. Go grab your who's who. I rep that north side till I die, and that's a blue. Lose clue. Look, I ain't never want the recognition. All praise is due, man. We in full submission. Now that I got your attention, you should know you got that juice too. Non-GMO, please don't let them people fool you. Power, yeah, power to the people. Yeah, all power to the people. Yeah, the power's in the people. In the streets mobbing, ripping good over evil. Look, power, power to the people. Yeah, all power to the people. Yeah. Powers in the people, burning and looting, repping good over evil. Look, juice.